Helix has some of the most advanced signal routing capabilities of any guitar processor on the market. So in this video, I'm going to take you through some of the more complex scenarios and show you just how flexible Helix is when it comes to routing audio.
Okay, so I've added two pedals to Helix. I've spun everything around so you can see the connections, and I've removed any cables from Helix that aren't connected to these pedals so it's easier to see. On the right side here, I have a Bogner Red Ecstasy pedal, fantastic distortion pedal. And on the left, I have an Echolution 2 delay from Pigtronics. Fantastic, from Dave Coltai and Company. Does a great job. And underneath that, I have a Voodoo Lab ISO 5 power supply powering these guys. Now, these are connected to the effects loops in Helix. So the Bogner is coming out of Effects Send 1 to the input, and the output of this pedal is returning to Effects Return 1. The Echolution 2 is actually a stereo in, stereo out pedal, but I'm only going to feed it mono and have it return in stereo. So I've got Effects Send 2 come to the input here, and I have the stereo outputs returning to Return 3 and Return 4. I'll also connect the MIDI to the Echolution 2 for another advanced video. However, these were too short by 2 inches, so I'll be using the world's longest MIDI cable to connect them, but stay tuned for that. All right, so everything is sort of all turned around and hooked back up and turned on so we can hear it. And we're going to run the distortion pedal, the Bogner, in front of the amp, and we're going to run the delay after the amp in sort of an interesting way. If you look here, you can see I have an effects loop in position 1, and I'm using effects loop 1, so that's where we connected the Bogner pedal, if you remember. I've assigned this block to a foot switch, and I've renamed the foot switch Bogner Red, so when I turn it on, I know what it is. So here's the sound we're starting with. It's just a plexi and some verb. So if I turn that Bogner pedal on, now you get crunchier. Okay, so let's involve this delay pedal. I've got it set to 100% wet, and I want to bring it back on its own pair of inputs so that it's discrete and it meets up with the guitar sound at the end. To create that situation, I'm going to come over to this screen here, and I'm going to create something cheap DSP-wise. There we go. And to move it down to this next path, remember I hit the action button, do that, and then hit the action button again. And now I've created this situation where I have a separate path going through this EQ. So the EQ has to be there because in order to create this second path, I have to have at least one block loaded there. So something cheap and inexpensive with a level control is what I'm looking for, so a cheap EQ. Now, what I'm going to do is come over to the end block where they merge, hit the action button again, and bring this down. So now I have the ability to have that path have a completely separate output. And I push this thing here, and I'm going to send it to send 1 and 2. Now, if you remember, we're using send 2 to feed the input of this delay. So I need to make sure that the pan is set all the way to the right so that it sends only out send 2 and doesn't send any more to that distortion pedal in send 1. So you can see that it's set there. Good. Now, using the Pac-Man thing, come down, and now you can see that the input of this path is set to return 3 and 4. So that's where the outputs of this delay are returning. So you can see I've got a pinch from the back of this amp, sending it out to a separate output, that's send 2, and it's returning to return 3 and 4, which is where this is. The last thing I want to be able to do is affect the level of the delay. And at the moment, the easiest way to do that is just assign the level of that simple EQ that I made to an expression pedal that I have on the floor. So if I bring the joystick over to the EQ, and I should probably assign that to a foot switch to make it easier to get to next time. There we go. And now I'm just going to press and hold the level button until it says Learn Controller. Push Learn, move the expression pedal, and there, it's learned it. And now I just want to make sure that the max level is unity at 0. There we go. Okay. There, now it's assigned. And if you look at that level, as I move the pedal, there you go. So now when I play the cleaner stuff at the beginning, I'll have the delay really loud, and then as I kick the distortion in, I'll bring it back a little bit so it doesn't overwhelm the distortion. So... As you can see, Helix is very powerful when it comes to routing audio. So make sure you check out all the other videos in the series, and then go up to line6.com, hit the dealer locator, and find a Helix certified dealer near you, and check one out today. Thanks and cheers.